WinCC version 8 step-by-step configuring button navigation.
In this section, we're going to hook up our navigation buttons to the child screens that we created previously. We're also going to set the default screen that will be shown in this picture window, and we're going to set some settings in WinCC Explorer to allow the picture to scale and show properly. So let's get started. First, I'll select the picture window, and I'll open my Object Properties dialog. I'm going to turn on the border, and I also want to go down and take a look at the picture name property. This is the property that causes the picture window to show a given picture. So I'll double click it, and I'll choose Overview as our default screen, and you can see that it shows a little thumbnail. So let's save this, and let's see what this looks like in runtime. I can just use the runtime button here to take a look. So in runtime, you can see that the work area is showing the overview screen, but our scale is off. So we're going to go to WinCC Explorer to fix this.
In WinCC Explorer, we're going to use the Deactivate Runtime toolbar button to turn off the runtime application. Next, I will double-click the server, and in the right-hand section for properties, I'll scroll down. And the window's attributes define how your runtime window looks and behaves. We'll turn on Adapt Picture, and this will make the picture grow or shrink based on how big we make the window. I'll also turn on Title so we have a place to grab the window and can move it around.
Going back to Graphics Designer, I'll save and go to Runtime. Now, if you don't previously close Runtime when you set those settings, they won't take effect until you stop and restart Runtime. So now you can see that our picture scales and we have a title and border, so everything looks good. So now we need to hook up our navigation buttons so that they navigate to the appropriate screens. So back in Graphics Designer, we'll go to the first button, which is Overview, and we're going to go to Events. We're going to use a mouse event on this button to update the picture name property on the picture window to show the correct screen. The piece of information that we need is the name of this picture window. And so I've got the picture window highlighted and it's called Picture Window 1. We can give that a better name just by highlighting the static value. And I'll just call this Pick Main Window. That way it's easy to pick out of a list. We want to change the picture name property of Pick Main Window using these buttons. So we'll go to the Overview button, choose Events, Mouse, and I'm going to use Press Left. I'm going to right click on the action and I'm going to choose Direct Connect. So this is the Direct Connect dialog and it allows us to put a piece of information in a target. So our source information is going to be the name of the page that we want to display. Our target is going to be the picture name property of our picture window object. So we have a picture browser here. We'll choose Constant, Picture Browser, and we're on the Overview button. So Overview is going to be my source information. For our target, we're going to choose Object and Picture. And since we've named our picture name something that is easy to pick out in a list, we can choose Pick Main Window, and then we're going to choose the picture name property, and I'll click OK. And you'll see that our action turns blue for a direct connect. So the way that you think about this is when the press left event is executed, it's going to take this value, OverviewPDL, it's going to put it in the picture name property of our main window, and that will cause the window to show the picture. Now, we will repeat those steps on the remaining button. So on Detail, I'm already on Object Properties, Events tab. I'll right-click, choose Direct Connect. And in this case, we want to choose Details. And then Pick Main Window, Picture Name. Admin. Alarms, and trends. Finally, I'll hit Save. I'd like you to notice when we go back to the Properties tab on the picture window, notice how miscellaneous is bold. This tells us that there is something configured under these sets of properties. And if we highlight that, we can see that picture name is italicized. That means that a direct connect is controlling it. So now let's take a look at what we've got. I'll hit Save and we'll go to Runtime. In Runtime, the default screen is the overview screen, so I'll try Detail. Now we're seeing the Detail screen. Here's the Admin screen, the Alarm screen, and the Trend screen. Now you may be able to tell that the scale of the picture window itself is not set to full screen. So we can also go fix that. Back in Graphics Designer, on the picture window, we'll set Adapt Picture to Yes. And that will correctly scale the pictures for the size of the picture window. We'll hit Save and just go to Runtime. Now you can see it's scaled properly and our controls show full screen. Also, if I change the size of my picture window, it will also scale appropriately because of the settings that we did on the base screen in WinCC Explorer and the settings that we did on the picture window for Adapt Picture. The last thing we need to do in this section is to get our page name text box to update with the name of the page that we're currently viewing. So let's go back to Graphics Designer. This static text one down here, the text property is what needs to be updated. We're going to use a direct connect on the picture window object to accomplish updating the text here. So I'm going to select the picture window object and I'll go to Events. And under Property Topics, Miscellaneous, we see a list of the properties. And if I go to the picture name property, you can see that there is an event for that property change. So events are triggered anytime a property changes. If you recall, the way that we're doing page navigation is the buttons are using direct connects to change the picture name property. So this event will be generated when the picture name property changes, and we can use this to update our static text box. I'll right click, choose direct connect. And since I am on a property change event, it automatically selects the exact property that's changing, and it has the value of the new page, such as overview.pdl, details.pdl. So I only have to fill out the target. So the name of that text box was static text one, and it is the text property that needs to be updated with the new picture name, and I'll just click OK. Finally, we want to set the default. Our default is to show our overview screen, so we will just type in overview.pdl as the default text, and then we'll save that. And we'll just hit Runtime. Now you'll see by default it says overview.pdl, and as we change the screen, the text is updated with the name of the new screen.